Yesterday, the Assembly Social Development Committee, which I chair, we tabled a report. We published a report which actually dealt with the allegations that the Minister Nelson McCausland had misled the committee and misled the Assembly in relation to meetings that he was having around contracts for double glazing windows, which were contracts involving millions of pounds of public money. The committee, in our inquiry, we held a number of evidence sessions. We have a very compelling body of evidence, and on the basis of the evidence presented to the committee believed very firmly, and that is all of the parties, with the exception of the DUP, reached a conclusion that the Minister, in fact, deliberately misled the committee.
Minister McCausland has responded by saying the report is weak at best. What's your response to that?
Well, as I've said, the committee, all the parties on the committee, with the exception of the DUP, were very firmly of the view on the evidence that we have received over a lengthy period of time that the Minister did, in fact, deliberately mislead the Assembly. And further, there was a concerted effort to conceal the record of the meetings. This was very seriously frowned upon by the members of the committee that represent the also Unionist Party, the TUV, the SDLP, the Alliance Party and Sinn Féin. All of those parties, with the exception of the DUP, concluded very clearly on the basis of the evidence presented that the Minister misled the committee. That's a very serious charge to level against the Minister, and I would urge the Minister to reflect on that. This report will be debated in full in the Assembly on the 8th of September. I would urge members of the public to read the report. There's a substantive body of evidence in there, and I would defy anyone to be able to challenge the professional integrity of the members of the committee and indeed the Assembly officials who service this inquiry, because any challenge to this report is in effect a challenge to the professional integrity of the officials and the committee members themselves, and I refute that. And I believe, and I'm quite confident, that this report will stand any scrutiny. And as I said, I would urge people to read the report. I would urge the Minister to reflect on the report, because the charges levelled by the committee are very serious charges, and the Minister, I would think, would be wise to respond appropriately.
Even though this is only stage one of the report, there already have been numerous calls for Minister McCausland to resign. What's your take on that?
Well, I've heard members calling on the Minister to resign. I am satisfied that the report is a damning indictment of a number of aspects, not least the Minister, but also aspects of the way in which the Department conducted themselves during this whole affair. I'm prepared to wait, and I will wait, as the Chair of the Inquiry. First of all, I will commend the report to the Assembly on the 8th of September, and the inquiry is not yet concluded, so I will rest my case and draw my final conclusions at the end of this inquiry, not midway through.
Sammy Wilson, Nelson McCausland's party colleague, is on record as saying this is a Sinn Féin-inspired witch hunt against the DUP minister. How would you react to that?
Well, I think it's unfortunate and foolish, actually, that the DUP would describe that as such, because to suggest that, you know, as they've described, it's a Sinn Féin-led committee, it's a partisan witch hunt, nothing could be further from the truth. All of the parties, with the exception of the DUP, have reached very firmly the same conclusions based on the evidence presented, including the evidence from the Minister himself. And to suggest that I was able to lead by the nose Jim Mallister, Dolores Kelly, Stuart Dixon, the Alliance Party, Michael Copeland of the Ulster Unionist Party, is a bit of a nonsense. All of those members conducted themselves professionally, and as the chair of that committee, I ensured that was the case. So I can stand over the professional integrity of the committee. That includes the officials of the Assembly who service the committee, and I would invite anyone, if they want to challenge the professional integrity of the committee, to do so, and I am very satisfied that no such challenge will emerge.